Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study how to design a binary search tree from given post order traversal sequence. Only one sequence is given to us, that is post order traversal sequence into this problem. A question may be asked in your examination for 10 marks. Construct a binary search tree from given post order traversal sequence. A post order traversal sequence elements are given to us. Then what would be the in-order traversal sequence? It means we have to also find in-order traversal sequence of it, and also we have to find the pre-order traversal sequence of it. Now in this problem, the post-order traversal sequence is given to us. So in the solution, we will copy that post-order traversal sequence given to us as it is, the given data. The elements are 1, 4, 7, 6, 3, 13, 14, 10 and 8. The property of binary search tree is that whenever we traverse any binary search tree, in in-order fashion, we always get the ascending order sequence of that particular data. So this problem is about binary search tree designing. It means that if I traverse this, if I arrange all this data into ascending order, I will get the in-order traversal sequence for this problem. So it is very easy to get the in-order traversal sequence from this. So the in-order sequence can be obtained by arranging this whole data into ascending order. The in-order traversal sequence of this data is 1, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 10, 13 and last element is 14. We just arranged the whole data into ascending order to obtain the in-order traversal sequence for this binary search tree. Okay. Now it is very easy for us to design a binary search tree from given post order and in order traversal sequence. We have already studied this type of designing of binary search tree from two sequences, that is post order and in order traversal sequence, in my previous videos. You can refer those problems also for designing the binary search tree. So I will now explain you how to design the binary search tree from these two traversal sequences. Post order and in order is available with us. As we know, in post order sequence, the root node always comes at the last. So it is very easy for us to find the root node of this tree. So 8 is the root node of this tree. The first job while designing a binary search tree is to find the root node of the tree. We found the root node as 8 here in this problem. 8 is the root node. After getting the root node, our job is to find the left child and right child of this root node. To get the left child and right child of this root node, we are going to refer this in-order traversal sequence. As we know, in-order traversal sequence, root always comes in between. Just go and check into the in-order sequence. Where is the root node? Root node is here. It is in between left and right part. The part which appears on the right side of the root node is called right subtree. So all these elements goes into the right subtree. Whereas the elements which appears on the left hand side will go to left subtree. This will go to the left subtree. Now we'll put it into the diagram. 8 is the root node. Left subtree elements are 1, 3, 4, 6, 7. All the data goes into left side, whereas the remaining data, that is 10, 13, 14, will go into the right subtree because all these elements are appearing on the right hand side of the root node 8. Now this is our second step of designing. In third step, we have to repeat step 1 and step 2 till the last element is considered in this diagram.
Okay,
so it means that in step 3 again we will go into the post order sequence to find the next root. To find the next root in post order, we go from right to left. We already found 8 as the root node. The next root after 8 is 10. So if you go into the diagram, where is 10? 10 is here. If we make 10 as the root node, 13 and 14 which are appearing on the right side will go to the right subtree, but there is no left element to the root node 10. So there is no left subtree for node 10. We'll draw it here. We are making 10 as the root node. That's why 13 and 14 goes into the right subtree. The remaining elements as it is 1, 3, 4, 6 and 7. All the elements as it is. This is the third step. In the fourth step, again we'll go and refer our data into the post order sequence. After root node 10, the next root is 14. Check into the diagram, where is 14? This is 14 here. After 13, there is 14 here. Okay. If we make 14 as the root node, what will happen? It does not have right side, so there is no right tree for root node 14, but it has left part, which has element 13. 13 will go to the left subtree of node 14. We'll write here 8 as the root node. To the right we have 10. Now we are making node 14 as the root node, and 13 which was appearing on the left side will go into the left subtree. The remaining data as it is, that is 1, 3, 4, 6 and 7. All elements as it is here. This is the next step now. Again we refer our post order sequence. After placing node 14, the next root is 13. Go and check it into the diagram. Where is 13? 13 is here and it is having single value. It means it is already placed. So we'll ignore it and we'll go to the next point. Next element after 13 is 3. Now we need to make 3 as the root node. Go and check into the diagram. Where is 3? 3 is here. So if you make 3 as the root node, what will happen? 1 will go to the left side, whereas 4, 6 and 7 which are appearing on the right side will go to the right side tree. So we'll draw it here. 8. We are making 3 as the root node now. So 1 will go to the left subtree. 4, 6, 7 will go to the right part. To the right of 8 we have node 10. To the right of 10 we have 14. And to the left of 14 we have node 13. We have successfully placed 3. After placing 3, again we will refer our sequences, traversal sequence. After node 3 into post order, check the next root. After 3, 6 is the next root. 6. We will refer our diagram. In this diagram, check where is 6. 6 is here. Where 4 is appearing on the left hand side of 6 and 7 is appearing on the right side. So 4 will go to the left subtree and 7 will go to the right subtree. We will write 8, 3, 1. We are making 6 as the root node. 4 will go to the left part. 7, right subtree. To the right of 8 we have 10. Here right 14. To the left of 14 we have 13. Now after placing 6 successfully, we will go and check into the post order sequence. We have to repeat all these steps till the last element is considered. After node 6, 7 is the next root. We will check it into the diagram. Here 7 is already placed. 7 is already placed because it is having only one value into the node. So we will skip that and we will go to the next element. After 7, 4 is the next root. check into the diagram. 4 is also placed because it does not have left and right child remain. Only one element is here. After 4 into the post order sequence, the next root is 1. Check into the diagram. 1 is also placed. It does not have left and right child remain. It means that all the elements now, if you see in the post order sequence, all the elements are covered. After 1, there is nothing. So, all the elements are covered. It means that this is our final binary search tree. This is the final binary search tree. Now, to check whether this binary search tree designed by you is correct or not, we will traverse this tree in post order and in order fashion. And if you get the same sequences, if you get these same sequences like this, then the tree designed by you is correct, otherwise it is wrong. Then the last part of this question is, we have to find the pre-order traversal of this problem. We know how to traverse any tree in pre-order. I am writing the pre-order traversal sequences for this diagram. In pre-order, we will refer the sequence as V, L, R, where we always visit the root node. V is the root node, L is the left subtree, R is the right subtree. It means that we have to visit root node first, then left subtree, then right subtree. So I'll directly write the pre-order sequence by using this algorithm. Root, left, right. Root, left, complete the left subtree traversal, and then you go to the right subtree. So the first element in pre-order traversal sequence is 3, 8. After traversing 8, the next element is 3. The next element to the left is 1. Then go to the right side. The next element will be, after visiting this 1, is 6. Then 4. Then 7. Root, left, right. Okay. 6, 4, 7. After 7, we have completed left part of this traversal. Then we will go to the right subtree. So the next element after 7 is 10 in pre-order. Then there is no left subtree here. So then we will go to the right side. Here it is 14. And the last element to be traversed in pre-order is 13. So this is the pre-order traversal sequence for the given binary search tree.